Friends and colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to start by thanking the International Organization for Migration for inviting me to be part of the high-level panel on human mobility, environment, and climate. I would also like to thank the IOM for integrating environmental and climate issues into all areas of work, policy, research, international migration law, advocacy, communication, capacity building, and your own operations. It is exceedingly important that every organization working towards multilateral solutions to international issues take a holistic and integrated approach. Because, as we well know, climate change is an issue that cuts across borders and economic sectors and truly touches everyone. Climate change multiplies and amplifies every critical phase, and if left unchecked, it will increase instability and contribute to involuntary migration and chaotic displacement. We know this because right now we have more clarity on the issue of climate change than ever before. The IPCC Fifth Assessment Report details the vulnerability of those without resources to migrate away from climate change impacts and the vulnerability of migrants who can't. The IPCC Fifth Assessment Report also shows with clarity that we can avoid high human costs of climate disruption through immediate transformation to low carbon and a long-term aim of climate neutrality in the second half of the century. And right now, we are seeing momentum build towards this transformation. People are marching in the streets in support of action. Business and investors are turning to renewables to lower costs and capture steady returns. Local and national policy increasingly points toward climate-safe growth. In the UNFCCC process, governments are working on a new universal climate change agreement with great potential to bend the emissions curve this decade and put us on a course to a long-term climate-neutral world. In this moment, as we approach the UN Climate Change Conference in Lima in December, where a draft agreement will emerge, and towards Paris in 2015, where that agreement will be adopted, governments need reasons and resources to take ever bolder action. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to give governments those reasons and those resources. Governments are waking up to the fact that climate change is a threat to economy, security, health, when the draft agreement is discussed by ministers across governments, they must understand that there are also migration reasons to act. Disentangling the climate signal from the rising tide of natural disasters can sometimes be tough, but the analysis is improving. The UN Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs and the Internal Displacement Monitoring Center has looked at data for 2008. It suggests that at least 36 million people were displaced by sudden onset natural disasters, with more than 20 million displaced due to the sudden onset of weather-related disasters, including about 6.5 million people because of floods in India. Research from other sources suggests that many millions of people are also displaced annually as a result of slow onset climate-related disasters such as drought. The military is also concerned. This year, the U.S. Department of Defense released a key report on climate change looking at future security concerns. The loss of glaciers will strain water supplies in several areas of our hemisphere, said Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel at a conference in Turin alongside the publication of the report. He further stated destruction and devastation from hurricanes can sow the seeds for instability. Droughts and crop failures can leave millions of people without any lifeline and trigger waves of mass migration. The IOM understands the need for resources and create actionable policy choices and has taken sizable strides towards creating these resources. I ask you to continue this invaluable effort. I would like to ensure that migration is considered in the varied and growing suite of resources that enable action. Resources are there or coming online, but governments must be connected with them to reap the benefits of a global transition to climate neutral development. Through this conference and your own influence, you can help make that connection and increase political will for ambitious mitigation targets and a commitment to adaptation in the new environment. Doing so minimizes the need to manage migration and maximizes our ability to stabilize the climate and promote low-carbon social and economic growth. Right now, we have the opportunity to preserve our national treasures, keep populations secure in their communities, and minimize climate-related migration from generations to come. We must seize this opportunity.
And we must do it maintenant et nous devons le faire ensemble.
And I look forward to seeing the outcomes.
J'attends avec intérêt de pouvoir prendre connaissance du résultat de cette réunion.
Well, let me then move.